Spectral signature curve is one of the basic aspects of remote sensing technology, because whatever we are going to identify about the Earth's surface features is based on its spectral response or the spectral properties of the objects that lay on the Earth's surface. So each object have some different spectral response that is depend on the orientation of the sun. Second, solar elevation angle. Look angle of the sensor. Topographic position. So there are several factors that is influencing the reflectance properties of the sun. And each and every object in our Earth surface, like vegetation, soil, water bodies, clouds, snow. So each and every features in our Earth surface have some different spectral properties and specific style of interacting with the incident radiation represented by the spectral response of the object. Now I come to let one by one, that is the spectral reflectance properties of the vegetation. Vegetation has distinctive spectral mark which permits to get separated from other kinds of the land cover features, especially in the visible and the near infrared region. In our earlier class, we have already discussed about the visible region and the near visible region, especially 0.4 to 0.7 micrometer of the electronic spectrum, and near infrared region 0.7 to 1.10 micrometer of the electron spectrum. So in this two wavelength region, the low reflectance pattern is found, especially in the blue and red region. In blue and red, suppose 0.4 to 0.5 micrometer, 0.5 to 0.6 micrometer, 0.6 to 0.7 micrometer. So, in this blue and red, these two wavelengths having a low spectral response comparison to green. And in the near infrared region, the reflectance is much more higher of the vegetation. If we consider in the mid infrared region, that is 1.3 to 2.5 micrometer. In this wavelength ranges, both the reflectance and transmission normally decline from medium to low. And the absorption rises as low to high. So when you are going to characterize the vegetation, we are considering the rate and habitat region that will help to identify the vegetation characteristics of the Earth surface. Now come to the spectral response of the soil. The reflectance properties of the soil depends mostly on the properties of the top layer. Right. It is influenced by the water content or moisture content. Chemical composition, texture, structure, of soil particles, etc. For example, if we draw a picture about the soil reflectance properties, suppose you can say so in case of very coarse sand, the reflectance is look like that. Whereas this is a very coarse sand. Fine sand. We can get the reflectance in this way. If we consider the silt, we may get the reflectance in this way. So there are different types of soil particles having the different types of reflectance pattern, and based on that we can identify the soil in our Earth surface. Another important, like moisture property, if we consider the moisture. So, soil having the larger moisture property, there is a dark tone. And low moisture content, the high moisture content, and gray tone and low moisture content. Soil having organic matter high organic matter of soil having black in color, and low organic matter soil having great brown tone. In the multispectral standard false color means
standard for this color image. Based on the size that I will discuss that, solving the different reflectance properties. So another important, the soil mineralogy. Like if we consider the basalt soil having dark tone, white, granite soil, light color. Now come to the spectral properties of the water. So there are three types of possible reflectance from the water bodies in the multispectral data, like surface reflectance, bottom reflectance. Another important characteristics, that is deep water bodies. For example, more than 2 meter, that is volume reflectance is very low. There is a volume reflectance is very low, like 6 to 8% in the visible portion of the concentration. In the multispectral data, we have seen this is a blue in color because there is a high reflectance in the blue band, whereas low reflectance in the green and red band. In panchromatic data, we have seen the water bodies are black in color. Another important characteristics like pure water bodies and shallow water bodies. Pure water bodies like deep blue color and shallow water bodies is the light blue color in the multispectral data. Now coming to the snow. Snow and clouds. Snow and clouds have definitely distinguished in the middle infrared wavelength and of the electron spectrum. Snow reflects more in the visible and near infrared region. Invisible and near infrared region, the reflectance pattern of snow is more. It also increases the near infrared wavelengths, but distant to near zero in the water absorption band. What are the water absorption band? Like 1.4 micrometer, 1.9 micrometer, and 2.7 micrometer. These are the water absorption band. That means in this wavelength, the water is absorbed and black in color in the image, satellite image. Whereas in clouds, in case of the clouds, what I have found, there is a shortwave, much more energy is reflected in the shortwave infrared band and the middle infrared domains. Shortwave infrared band and middle infrared domains. That is 0.82. In this wavelength, there is a much more higher reflectance has been found. Thank you for observing this video and share the same.